This is the GTX 760, a card that's almost 10 years old, being released back in June of 2013. With the age of this card, it's no longer officially supported by Nvidia in terms of driver support, but with the existing drivers you can play almost any game out there, at least for now. Today, the GTX 760 can be found for under $50 on secondhand sites like eBay. Taking a look at the ports on this card, we have two DVI ports, an HDMI port, and a DisplayPort. This seems rather limiting by today's standards, but I guess if you're buying this card, you're probably not going to be running two high refresh rate monitors through a DisplayPort anyway. This particular card is the MSI GTX 760 Twin Frozer model with a built-in overclock. But anyways, after fixing up this card, I cleaned off the thermal paste, applied new, and I dusted off the rest of the card, making sure that it would perform as it should with no hindrance in performance due to any dirt or grime left over. After cleaning up the card, I threw it into a test bench running an i7-4790K at 4GHz and 32GB of DDR3 at a rather slow speed of 1600MHz, but since this is an Intel CPU, it shouldn't be as dependent on fast RAM to run more efficiently as opposed to if we were running an AMD processor. Now running a couple of benchmarks, starting out with Rainbow Six Siege, a game which is very well optimized for older hardware. At 1080p low settings, we get a surprising average frame rate of 113. In Fortnite, at 1080p competitive settings, we get an average frame rate of around 75. Though in Fortnite, the frame rate will spike and drop frequently, so take this with a grain of salt. Once again testing Fortnite, but this time with the performance mode on, we get a surprisingly good frame rate of 140. Going over to Overwatch at 1080p high settings, which the game actually recommended, we get an average frame rate of 80, a somewhat surprisingly playable experience. But once again, this is a game that is optimized for older hardware, so it's not that surprising.
I'm ready for
I then tried dropping the graphics settings to low, and we get a very solid experience of around 155 frames per second. This would be great for a budget system where you prefer to have higher frame rate even if it's on lower graphical settings. Moving on to a more modern AAA game, Shadow of the Tomb Raider. This one is more of a mixed bag. At 1080p high graphics, the card is able to dish out around 25 frames per second average. While this isn't bad for the card, as it's almost 10 years old, I wanted to see if I could get something closer to 60 FPS in this benchmark. Dropping the settings to medium, we get an average of 35 FPS, which actually is not bad, and it's still very playable. But I wanted to see if we could get any more performance out of this card, so I dropped the graphics settings all the way down to low, and we get an average frame rate of 48, which isn't the 60 FPS mark I was hoping to hit, but I was decently surprised by this card, considering it's running outdated drivers and only has 2GB of VRAM. So overall, in 2022, is this card worth it? Well, if you can find the card for less than $50, I would say absolutely. This card would be great for budget builds or just to have a card to throw into an existing system just to allow you to play semi-modern games. If you enjoyed this video, let me know in the comments, and also let me know what you'd like to see next. And if you made it this far into the video, maybe consider subscribing and turning on the notifications so that you can see the next time I post a video and you never miss an upload. Thanks for watching.